Hello all, thank you for joining. We are just about ready to do some ZF coffin runs. I am a level 50 mage, and this is pretty easy to do. You have probably seen a video of this once before. It is good to do, good XP, half decent gold, and pretty easy to do. So let's go and do a run or so, and hopefully you can enjoy what you see. Leave a comment if you do. I should just go over my gear. My gear is just stuff that has dropped or that I've bought off the auction house. It's nothing great, but it does the job. You want to try and have at least about, well, depending on your level. I started at level 44, and I had less than 3k mana, and it was hard. So you want to have around 3k mana. Level 44, 45-ish, and you should have no problems doing it. You will be using level 1 spells for Blizzard. There is my talent spec right now. Mostly it is Frost. You want to make sure you have your improved Blizzard. I use Shatter. You could, later on you can get rid of Shatter, but right now Shatter's good. And yeah, so it's 37 talent points. It's an AoE mage farming. You can look it up on Icy Veins and other websites to see the talents. And so here we go. This is gonna be, what I do is I get my shields up right off the bat, and then I'm just gonna run through these mobs. And depending on your level, you will either aggro them or you don't. If you do, it's okay, just keep running. You don't want them to hit you from behind, because if they do hit you from behind, they will have a chance to stun you, and then you have to get to the safe spot faster. The first safe spot is actually right in there, they're right in the, between the middle, but because I am a little bit higher level, I am just going to run right past it and go to the second safe spot, which is coming up right here, and you just want to just jump. There you go, right into the middle. And these guys will despawn and disappear. And I'm just gonna rebuff again for my barriers. I just got in combat, so I just gotta wait. And here we go. And now we're gonna run right to the coffin run room there. And you're not gonna stop. If for some reason you do get knocked off near the bugs, that's okay, because there is a safe spot on the urn, which I will show as we're gonna go past it here right away. So just right in this corner right here is where the safe spot is. You just jump up behind it and you'll be fine. This guy I like to mark just so I know where he is. And then the other safe spot, there's two of them. Here's one right here. Well, there's a couple of them actually. Here's one here. And the other one is just in the corner here. This is where your primary one is going to be used mostly. Because you're going to have to jump up on this guy's face. Go all the way up to the top, and then you will jump across the ledge, and that's where you will, and then you'll mount up, and then you'll start the boss. What you want to do is you're going to just, I'm just waiting for the pap to go by here. And then I'm going to open up all these graves. And I'm going to try to anyways. Almost all of them. And then I'm going to jump back up to here. And then up the face. And then back up to where I'm at right now. I'm going to then get different armor on. Mage armor. And then I will then AoE. Level 1 rank. You start the boss because when you click on the graves, then they will run to the boss. And this is the next safe spot. You're just going to hide here until they all disappear. And I'm going to rebuff my ice barriers, my shields, and then I am going to start clicking on the next ones. If you go behind the pillars there, they actually take longer because then the bobs actually go around, they don't go through. So that's a little trick. Yeah, if you're getting, you can ice frost them like I did there, Frost Nova, and then just go between it. It saves you a little bit of time anyways. I'm just gonna get my shields up again. And then I'm actually just gonna jump right back up because the guy will respawn. And now we're gonna start the run here. Again, I change up my spells, so I use my mage armor. I use amplified magic. I'm just gonna rebuff my intel, even though I didn't have to. I mount up, and I jump into the corner. Once you're up in the corner, then you just go to the side. And I like to have full mana. You will want full mana, especially at lower level. Because if you don't, it is just... Because this is a mana race. You're going to be using level 1 rank Blizzard. I do have level 1, and then I also have my big one, level rank 4. Just for the big hits, because I do it what I like to call the sweet spot. Because they go up the hill, then down, and then back up on the ledge. So that's why I like to call it the sweet spot. So I start the boss, and then I start doing level 1 ranks. Blizzard. Of course I fell and I died. skeletons that come, I'm not too worried about. They don't hit very hard, and I can just AoE them. I just ignore them. I waited too long. I'm gonna ice block, and I'm gonna hopefully frost them all here. Frost blank. Blank frost. Missed it. Okay, I'm gonna just shield up, and then I am gonna just pull. This time I'm gonna have a little timer on it, just to show you how fast it can take. Or give a rough estimate anyways. So here we go. The nice thing at my level is that I can bypass a lot of these guys. Which is nice. As you can see, I'll just refresh it. It's almost all mages other than one rogue. So this is mage farming. And a lot of mages are doing it right now. I just rebuffed my shields, and then I will go straight to the coffin room. Got stunned there because when they hit you from behind, they can stun. So that's why I tried to go to the side, but obviously it wasn't far enough. So it's okay though, because I wasn't too worried. So I'll now start the boss again. Just get a little bit of mana. I missed three in the corner and then the one guy. That's okay, I guess. No big deal. I'm only using rank one spells just to group them up and doing the Mario jump back and forth. I will now use a rank four max rank right here. And this will double, triple hit them. Maybe more, hopefully. And this is where you can really burn them down. And then I just jump over again. It's all about the Mario jumping. If you can do the Mario jumping, you got this down. It really, really is. And since that other guy's gonna die right away, the non-elites die really fast. Or they can anyways. I try not to kill them on the hill just because of the loot, because I like to get the loot. See, there they go. He died right there. I am already Uma, but that's okay. I will evocate here. I'm just going to just blast him a little bit, and then I'll evocate. I'll just wait for full mana. Which came close, but then I will do Blizzard rank 1 there, and then full 1 there. Of course that guy right there is gonna screw me up, but that's okay. And if you do fall, like if they are on that side, and if you do fall, it's fine, because then you can just get back up over the side. But if they're on this side here and you fall, it's just a shorter distance for them to get to you. So that's how I died the first two times. As you can see, they're slowly dying now. I'm just gonna bring them over again. I'll either try and kill them on this side of the hill or this side over here, just because I like to get them in that sweet spot. I don't like to kill them right there, because then the loot gets hard to get. So that's just FYI. Loot is harder to get if you kill them right up on top of the hill here. But there you go. Simple run. Took me a whole 9 minutes, almost 10 minutes to do. And that was from start to finish. Now hopefully I can get some good gear. Even though the gear is not for gear. It's not. The coffin guys don't drop a whole lot. You got the odd stuff, but it's all random. And so what I'll do is I'll just reset it again and do it again. I'm only 2.5 bars away to level, so I will continue to do this until I am 51. So enjoy.